We're going to talk about Sudoku, and in particular something called the Fistermefell ring.
Fistermefell ring?
Well, it's named after a German Sudoku constructor called Fistermefell, who discovered it a couple of years ago. And it's a property that exists in all Sudoku puzzles, but not many people know about it. And it's got quite a lovely proof, and it might blow your mind.
It might, all right.
It might.
Is it useful? Like, is this like a secret that will help people solve Sudokus?
It can definitely help you solve some Sudokus. And yeah, maybe, shall I show you? So maybe while I'm doing this, I'll tell you, I'm sure everybody watching Numberphile knows the rules of Sudoku. The idea of Sudoku is you have to put the numbers 1 to 9 just once each into every row, every column, and into every 3x3 box. That is our Sudoku. And what I'm going to show you now is something called set equivalence theory. So we know that in this Sudoku, if we complete it correctly, there'll be the numbers 1 to 9 once each in every row, column, and box. So I'm now going to highlight some cells in red. So I'm going to highlight row 3, row 7, this box, this whole box here, and box 6. And the interesting thing about those four things I just highlighted is, because of the properties of Sudoku, we don't know what the disposition of the digits will be within those red cells, but we do know exactly what those red cells contain altogether, because it's four complete sets of the digits 1 to 9. One for this row, one for this row, one for this box, and one for this box. So altogether, we know that the red cells here contain four sets of the digits 1 to 9. Now, I'm going to switch to green, and I'm going to highlight a different four sets of the digits 1 to 9. So I'm going to highlight the whole, can we see that that's green? So I'm going to highlight the whole of column 1, the whole of column 2, the whole of column 8, and the whole of column 9. Okay, so now let's describe the green set of digits. That's also four sets of the digits 1 to 9, one for each of the columns. So at this point, we know that the set of the green cells, if you like, and the set of the red cells are identical, each equal to four sets of the digits 1 to 9. Now, the trick to understanding the Fistermefell ring is to focus on one of these cells that has two colours in it. So let's look at this cell here. And imagine that we removed it from both the green set and the red set. So let's imagine that we just take this out. I'll make it blue. So I'm removing this from both the green set and the red set. What can we say about the remaining cells now in green and red? And the thing we can say is that they still contain the same set of digits. We don't know now exactly what that set of digits is, because we don't know what digit will fill in row 3, column 1 in the final solution. But we do know that the red set and the green set are still equivalent. They're still equal. And we can do that for every single cell in this puzzle that contains both colours. We can remove it from both the green set and the red set. Let's now focus on what we've got left now. So we know at this point that the green and the red sets are still equivalent. And if we look at the red set, you can see 16 cells here ringing the central box of the Sudoku. Now this is the Fistermefell ring. And we know that that is exactly the same digits as appear in the four corners of the Sudoku, these four 2x2s in the corners. And you can try this on any Sudoku you solve on your train home, fill it in, and then ring this central box and compare those digits to the corners 2x2s, and you will find that this works. It works for every Sudoku, and I think it's quite magical.
One of the questions that pops into my head is, could you make any other shapes or configurations on a grid that have this property?
Brady, you are brilliant. Yes, you can indeed. And in fact, there's a famous Dutch constructor called Aard van de Wetering, who found another trick. He found that there's a square in the top left of a Sudoku and a square in the bottom right of the Sudoku that have a relationship using exactly this trick. And we've even seen puzzles now where you can use this feature to create the difference of squares equation in Sudoku form. It sounds completely crazy, but you can see it on the screen here. And you can create some mathematics out of the geometry of Sudoku that actually can yield to some really beautiful results. So, and it's very, very much in sort of really advanced Sudoku solving, this equivalence of different parts of the geometry of the grid is important and can be, it can crack some fiendish puzzles.
Check the links on screen and below to see another video about that mathematical Sudoku that Simon just mentioned. And to see Simon and his offsider Mark solving all sorts of puzzles, check out their amazing YouTube channel, Cracking the Cryptic. Again, links below. Thanks for watching this video, and thank you to our Patreon supporters. You're seeing some of their names on the screen at the moment, and you can also see me signing these unique primes in the post. I'll be mailing these out to most of our supporters later this month. What prime number will you get? I might even send twin primes to some people.